Hey everybody, welcome back to Live Free and Tool On in this week's episode of Ryobi Weekly. And boy, do we have a not-so-action-packed week, because everyone is still so full from Thanksgiving, and I'm sure that you are not tired of eating turkey every single day for the past week, for every single meal, making it into a soup, making it into a stew, making it into sandwiches, making it into anything you possibly can in order to eat all of that turkey. So I hope that everybody had a fantastic Thanksgiving, and I hope you had a great Black Friday. Now, with that being said, we don't have too many sales that I've seen with Home Depot. We've just seen a few tools come out, such as the inverter. It started hitting stores. We are starting to see a lot more of the Link systems actually in stores too, so you can pick those up now. Not everything, at least not the mobile tool storage that I've seen. I haven't seen a lot of that. I have seen the wall stuff though. Everything that you can hang on the wall of the organization, and a lot of the hooks are in stores now too. But in the way of sales, not too much. We just had Black Friday, so they're going to build that up until around Christmas, and they are still continuing the $99 sale. It's just nothing new. They're just still continuing with that. I don't know when that's going to end. Over at Direct Tools, though, they are doing some different sales as they do every single week. They're doing a 20% off factory blemished and 30% off factory reconditioned cordless power tools. And power through the holidays. Get a free supercharger when you buy a 3, 6, or 10 pack of 2-amp batteries. I tell you, they are really trying to get rid of these batteries. I see them everywhere, and they're getting cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. Now, jumping into industry news, this is actually really cool. So over in Denmark, they started selling the HP tools. Now, I search all pages around the world, so I'm trying to get the up-to-date news to really spread the good word, right? And they started getting the HP tools. Here's a few pictures of their displays and how they're really pushing the product out there. Now, I would like you to take this picture and compare it to what we're seeing at Home Depot. Their advertisement there is much better. Their lighting is better. Their displays are better. I'm really actually impressed. So maybe their tools over there, or at least Ryobi, is on a higher level, maybe on the Rigid or maybe on the Milwaukee level over there. I'm not sure what other tool brands that they have, but it's pretty impressive that I saw that. So this was shared by Sunny Lemvig Nielsen, and thank God Facebook has a translation service, so I always communicate with them and I write back and forth whenever I can, and it really allows the opportunity for us to see what's going on in different countries, so that's really awesome. I'm glad to see it. Glad to see you all have the tools going on there, and hopefully you're posting some of your project pictures too, so we can see what you're doing over there. Now, with all of the Link systems that are coming out and all the focus on tool organization, well, there's one person that shared his tool organization that he built himself. This is Rob McKee. Now, he has a YouTube channel, and it's pretty popular too, but he shared this video, or at least he made it a few years ago, and he felt the need to share it again. Now, what I'd like for you to do is check out the picture and look what type of storage solutions that he's creating for himself. I think it's really creative. I think that he's got something going on here, like the multiple layers of storage that you have kind of on a rolling bookshelf, a horizontal rolling bookshelf. It just shows some of the alternatives if you make it yourself. Give Rob a shout too. Let him know if you like it or not. So I usually don't get a lot of stuff from the Ryobi Do-It-Yourself group, but this time I got a couple things. This is one from John Reinhardt. He repurposes a barrel, he's made a cart, he's done a couple other things, and I thought it was really cool, and it shows a lot of craftsmanship there, a lot of creativity, so I wanted to share it with everyone. And it's unusual too, it's not like you're building a workbench or you're doing, you know, putting up trim somewhere. He's actually taking something, he's creating it, and I thought it was pretty awesome. So, John, I really like what you're doing. I hope you continue to share some of your skills and some of your creativity with us, and you know, help people to get inspired and do the same thing. Okay, so now we're heading over to the Ryobi Tool Users Group 2.0, and this is a catastrophic failure. Now, I talked to the person who posted this. He said it was not his post. He reposted it, and it's a few years old. But I'd like you to take a look at this. It looks like they're taking lug nuts off. This is an electric drill. Well, it didn't fare too well. Before something gets this bad, I don't know if this was instantaneous, but it's pretty entertaining to look at, but also it brings up a lot of safety concerns for me as well. A, it's electric, so when something like this happens, the first thing you have to do, A, is stop using it. B, go plug it out. Get the tool outside to a non-combustible surface. Make sure that you understand if it does catch on fire, you have to do that before it catches on fire, but if it does catch on fire, this is an electrical fire. It's just a safety moment for us to talk about here, and just keep that top of mind. If you do have a fire, know what type of fire you have, because you have A, B, and C, D, and E. But if it is it a typical fire with wood and combustibles? Is it an oil fire? Is it an electrical fire? You know, chemical fires, you really have to be aware of the situation and educate yourself as well. Oh, and here's my shameless plug for my amazing, for one of my videos I made this week. So I picked up the Hercules brushless line from Harbor Freight, and this is the reciprocating saw, and I wanted to head-to-head it with Ryobi. I also have the Cobalt XTRs as well, and I put them head-to-head, and it was surprising because the Hercules had some surprising results. Here's the link. Check the link out down below. Go watch the video for yourself. Make your own opinions for it. I tried to be as non-biased as possible in order to get this done, but I hope that you enjoy the video. It took me a while to make, and I was very surprised, and I hope that you're surprised too. Now what I'd like to do is take a minute to recognize the Ryobi Revolution page, and he's on this these weekly videos a lot, and I don't intend to do it. He's just active in the community, and he's always putting new things out there. But this is Matt Robbins, or Matthew Robbins. He does what's called a morning coffee with everyone, and he talks about cool and interesting things, whether it's history or it's technology or comparisons. And he really it's a conversation starter, and it's thought-invoking as well. So go over to his page, look up some of the morning coffees, and it's just a chat between everyone on the page of some of the really interesting things that are going on in the industry or technology. But I really like to highlight that because it really does bring the community together, and it brings up new topics, which, you know, we need that. So, you know, thanks, Matt. Everyone check him out and continue what you're doing, because everyone really appreciates it. Now it's the holiday season. We are getting ready for Christmas. So Scott Oram, he's ahead of the game. He's already put out a video, and he's making the smallest Shadow military box that's ever been made. And why not? It's an ornament. He actually made an ornament. So check him out. Here's a screenshot. But what I would like for you to do, or like for you to do, like I'm in charge of you. But if you could, go down below, hit the link, check out his video on how he makes it. I think it's really interesting. I haven't seen something like this before, but in order to articulate and make something so small and make it look so quality, I'm very impressed with it. So check out his page, check out what he's doing. He's supporting the community, so let's support him back and you know, go check out his videos there. And last but not least, I have been working on designs on new and cool merchandise and new and cool designs for everyone. And with that being said, here is my new Ryobi Forest theme. Now with this, I took a lot of time and I did a lot of layers within this design. So I hope that you all can appreciate it. And I hope that it really brings out some creativity as well for everyone. So I'll have these in my store as well if you want to buy some stickers. And then also, with that being said, I have new hats in. I have a limited run of camouflage. You can see I have a mesh hat. This is a button back, so it's adjustable back, and it's a mesh hat. It's camouflage, not something I typically retail, but I was able to get a limited run of these hats. And you can see I actually have a new design. This is part of the Ryobi Forest theme, and I actually have the trees within the Ryobi logo itself, and I have that on the front of the hat. I also put the Ryobi wood logo on it as well, and it's in white, and I have that in green. I thought that was really good because people are really interested in this Ryobi wood grain theme. So I'm really trying to get some cool new merch out to everyone so we can support the brand and, you know, really just make some cool stuff. So I hope that you appreciate it. And if you do like it, you know, look down below. I have my store that's open, and you can get to it. It's on Etsy, and the link is below. So everyone, that's it for this weekly update. There really wasn't much out there. I know everyone is still full from Thanksgiving. Everybody's trying to get in the swing and change over from Thanksgiving to Christmas, and everyone's listening to the Christmas music. So everyone, thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell, because you don't want to miss any of this amazing content. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care, everybody.